Cape Cod Regional Government Assembly of Delegates. I'd like to, before I call the meeting to order, there's no one recording this besides our regular recording. Okay, and also before I call to order, I'd like to congratulate Pat Princey on the new addition to his family.
Faith in a growing America.
A future politician, I can tell right away. Okay, so we'll now call the meeting to order and begin with a moment of silence to honor our troops who have died in service to our country and all those serving our country in the armed forces. Thank you, and we'll now stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Clerk will call the roll.
Richard Anderson. Cheryl Andrews.
Here.
Ronald Bergstrom.
Here.
Leo Kukunis.
Here.
Ned Hitchcock.
Here.
Christopher Kenega. James Killian.
Here.
Marcia King.
Here.
Teresa Martin.
Here.
Suzanne McAuliffe.
Here.
Deborah McCutcheon.
Here.
John Omen. Patrick Princey.
Here.
Anthony Scalise.
Here.
Julia Taylor.
Here.
Mr. Speaker, we have a quorum present with 81.54% of the delegates present, 18.46% absent.
Thank you. I'll now need a motion to approve the calendar of business.
So moved.
Second.
Been moved and seconded. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? You should have received a copy of the Journal of March 5th, 2014. Are there any additions or corrections to the journal?
Move to accept.
Second.
Okay, moved and seconded. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, now we come to our favorite section of the agenda, the communications from the Board of Regional Commissioners. We have a live commissioner here in our stage.
Introduce yourself.
Oh, for those of you who forgot who I am, I'm Phil Doherty. I'm a Barnstable County Commissioner. I've been proudly serving as such for 12 years. Actually, 13 if you count the years that I was given credit for because I sat in November. However, the only thing I have to report as far as ongoing activities, that we did discuss the responsibility that we had to Patrick to take a look at his request for funding. So we did put that should be going on the agenda for discussion next week. You should see that. Other than that, we had several reports from the Economic Development Commission. There's in 2015 is going to be an oyster week that is going to be down here. So I'm really excited about that because it's an international conference.
Is your mic on, Bill?
I remember Tommy Bernardo did this to me once and shut it off on purpose. Maybe he's just not used to having time anymore.
Maybe you're not plugged in here.
Well, I've heard that problem before. Well, I could speak really loud.
You're on now.
All right, so in any case, there were a lot of reports that were made. I want to congratulate the fact that Leo was there at our meeting and offered some comments with regard to some of the things that we were looking at. What else did we do, Leo? I don't remember all of it. We did so much through the chair. But in any case, the IT made a report on where they are on a draft basis. There was a request to approve the beginning of contract negotiations with regard to the Open Cape and Cape Net as far as moving forward in that. That's about the sum and substance of the economic development. People came in to talk about where they're allocating funds. So it's just sort of a general discussion. The economic development people, have they not come over here?
No.
Okay. I think Marcia would appreciate that if they came on after talking
about it. No, Marcia would.
I always live in hope.
Anyway, any questions for Commissioner Doherty? Yes, Leo.
Remember, on the open meeting laws, I don't think I'm allowed to talk about anything that isn't on your agenda, but go ahead, Liz.
No, I did attend the meeting, but I just wanted, you did mention the strategic information technology plan, and I would like to just, you know, give that a little kind of a real star of importance, especially for my fellow colleagues here on the assembly. I believe you all have it emailed to you. I know I got it as a member of the finance committee. It's 70-plus pages. There's going to be a quite large commitment of county government to this department, and I would ask through Bill that we all really pay some close attention to it as we near the budgetary talks, because this department is really, really moving forward, and I encourage everyone to look at that plan.
Thank you, Leo. I appreciate your response, because it is an important area.
Anybody else? Well, thank you very much.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, are there any communications from public officials? Any communications from members of the public?
Michael's here, if you want to.
I don't know if anybody has any questions for our administrator.
If you wanted one, maybe you.
No, we're all set so far. We'll grill him in the budget, when the budget comes. The assembly will now convene, and we will start with committee report with end minutes from the Health and Human Services Committee. That would be...
Mr. Chairman?
Do we have a quorum?
No, we don't.
We don't?
So we have to skip over that today.
Okay. The Finance Committee report on proposed ordinance 14-02. I guess this is going to go to you, Leo.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. John's not here, so I'm going to be reading this. It was March 12, 2014. We had a public hearing on proposed ordinance 1402. 1402 has two sections in it. The first section covers the county dredge for a total of $221,000. That is broken into five different areas. The gist of it is that, first of all, there has been a broken dredge pump, which happened over on the island, and there's some repair costs of $101,000. There was also a rental of a large machine, an excavator, because of the subsequent problems with that broken pump and getting the pump out, getting the dredge moved. The other three items under that category are really related to some new work that is coming in that was not anticipated. So some of this money we will be recouping, because obviously when we fund ahead of new projects, we charge for the dredge and we get that money back. The dredge repair obviously is one that was just unforeseen. So I happened to motion, and it was seconded, to recommend approval to the full assembly of proposed ordinance 14-02, section 1. Mr. Chairman, Mr. Speaker, would you like me to just make a full report on both of the sections, or do you want to go ahead with a motion on each section?
You know, that brings up an interesting point, Leo, because we have one ordinance in front of us with two sections, so I don't know if that's...
If I may, Mr. Speaker, yeah. I did ask that question specifically because this situation has come for us before, and that's why this actually is broken into two sections. Ironically, both sections, and if you don't mind, I will give the report on the second half of proposed ordinance 1402, but the outcome is the same. We voted in favor of it. If I had... One was negative and one was plus, I probably would ask the floor to maybe take
Well, I can take a vote on both sections of the ordinance if that's the case. And if they both pass, then they both pass. If they don't, then we may have to do some little parliamentary tricks.
Well, just to give you a report then on section 2, if I may, Mr. Speaker.
Yeah.
We had the member of the Fire Training Academy in front of us. This is specifically directly related to the increases of the salary line of the budget. There is an increase in people coming and using the facility, so obviously we have to back end the paying of the people to be there to help. Specifically, there's an increase in Mass Maritime. We've also even taken on some new ones, New England Maritime and the New England Bedford Fire Department. I'm sorry, New Bedford Fire Department. I would like my colleagues to know that this expenditure of $19,500 is in fact going to return to the general funds around an estimate of around $31,000. So quite frankly, it's money well spent. With that said, I did make a motion, and it was seconded, to recommend the approval to the full assembly for the proposed ordinance 1402 section 2 and the amount of $19,500 for the Fire Academy. Right. And that's my report.
Okay.
Mr. Chairman?
Yep.
Mr. Speaker, we do have a quorum for Health and Human Services.
Yeah, I just realized that. I'm going to take that after. We'll go back to that after we do this. Okay. Leo, did ever been discussed to the Finance Committee how the funds that are come in to pay for this are handled? I know that if we have an expense, we have to list it, and it has to be spent through an ordinance. But you know, there's no evidence of that. Even though we know that the funds are coming, what's the evidence that they're coming? Do you inform how they are presented to us? Or?
Well, the first section of this proposed ordinance is specifically for the county dredge. And the county dredge, if you will, is basically a revolving fund situation. The money goes out of the county dredge account, and whatever monies we do make, we put back into specifically that line item in that account. It gets a little kind of, I don't want to say confusion, but you need to actually take a look at it when we get close to the fiscal year, because there are projects that obviously extend over the fiscal year where we've dedicated monies. We haven't started the project yet, but once again, the monies for the first half of this proposed ordinance are in fact a designated revolving fund for the county dredge. Okay. The second one, however, is monies that will come out of the general fund of the county coffers, and quite frankly just gets returned back in there. I guess it's our due diligence to look at the line items when FY15's budget comes back to see that we in fact are meeting the projected income revenue coming in from that department. In your budget books, it does have specific line items for budget revenues. Okay. And I did ask that question specifically with the Fire Academy because I wanted to know if the 19.5 needed to be also included in FY15's budget, but I was told at that time that it was not necessary because they feel they're going to be tweaking their business, if you will, and be able to cover it with what they're requesting. I hope that answers your question.
Yeah, it does. It does pretty much. Does anyone have any other questions about this? Okay, we're going to take a vote on proposed ordinance 14-02, which includes both of these expenditures. And
Mr. Speaker, do you actually need a motion to do that? I know my report said subcommittee did it, but
yeah. Well, no,
I'll move the report. I'll move the ordinance as.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not trying to add any confusion to this, but you know how you see my point is I've got an ordinance in front of me, and it's got several things in it, you know, and really it should be presented as two different ordinances, but if we
could be, but
yeah, okay, well, we'll see what happens here.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Okay. Any other further questions? We'll take a vote on this.
Cheryl Andrews.
Yes.
Ronald Bergstrom.
Yes.
Leo Kukunis?
Yes.
Ned Hitchcock?
Yes.
James Killian?
Yes.
Marcia King?
Yes.
Teresa Martin?
Yes.
Suzanne McAuliffe?
Yes.
Deborah McCutcheon?
Yes.
Patrick Princey?
Yes.
Anthony Scalise?
Yes.
Julia Taylor?
Yes.
Mr. Speaker, proposed ordinance 14-02 passes with 81.54% of the delegates voting yes, 18.46% are absent, now known as Ordinance 14-01.
Okay, thank you. I'll now go back to the Health and Human Services minutes for approval, and we'll go to Suzanne.
The minutes have been made available on the website to everyone if you haven't had a chance to read them. And I believe we voted on every group that came before us with a recommendation except for the Human Rights Commission because there was a discrepancy in what they were asking for and what they were funded by the County Commissioner. So going forward, I think I'm going to need a little bit more information to know what the, how the discrepancy sorts out. But the Human Services Committee did recommend all the other subgroups that came forward for their budgeted amounts with that exception, because we weren't sure what happened to the request versus the funding. In addition, there were one or two items in the Human Rights Commission that we weren't sure what the rationale was for, in terms of increasing a director's salary by $5 an hour and not increasing their hours, things like that. So that's just so that you know that there were some questions on a specific subpart of the Human Services budget, and that's the Human Rights Commission. Not big money, but just little questions.
Yeah. Suzanne, if your committee, the committee members present have gotten the minutes, we usually approve the minutes, so you basically need a motion to approve the minutes.
Okay. can I have a motion to approve the minutes?
I would move that we approve the minutes from the okay. committee meeting.
So we've got, who's here, who else is here?
It's Tony, Patrick, myself.
Okay.
And then Deborah's on the committee, she just wasn't at
Well, we have enough to approve the minutes, supposing no one objects. Okay, so we've motioned to approve the minutes in second.
Your second?
Yep.
Second.
Okay, so you're running the show, so you have to call for a vote.
Okay, yeah. All those in favor? Thank you.
Okay, so. Do we now have a report from the clerk?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Today concluded our last committee meeting for budget review. The next meeting will be April 2nd, and that will be a meeting with finance and all the chairs of the standing committees, with the exception of government regs. And I believe it is the 16th of April, just to fast forward a little bit more, will be your public hearing on the budget. And that's the budget news for now. With regards to a statement that was made earlier by the delegate from Harwich, I did receive a copy of the IT report, the strategic report. I did forward it to the committee as I was requested to do, but I have not yet forwarded it to the full assembly. And I will do that tomorrow morning, so be on the lookout for that in your mailbox. Mm-hmm. And that's it for today.
Okay, is there any other business to be brought before the assembly? Yes, Leo.
As I expressed earlier when Bill was up, I did attend the commissioner's meeting, and there was a report filed by the CDC license plate money, and I have a copy of it here for those of you that maybe didn't get it when you came in a little late. I want to make sure that everybody, and I will give a copy to the clerk so she has for our files too. And the second thing, if I may, Mr. Speaker, there's a movement abreast, every one of our towns have seen this, in regards to talking about withdrawing from the Cape Cod Commission. And I'd like to know if it's if it can be maybe figured into our time frame that I believe that we should at least put it on our agenda, maybe after the budget is done, to at least talk about it. I mean, we are representatives of our communities, and if this action does move forward, I believe it would be an impact to county government, and I think we need to at least address it. And you know, I respectfully request maybe that the speaker think about putting it on the agenda for a future discussion. Thank you.
I can do that, Leo, and I'll contact the commission to get the understanding of how the act was passed, who has started to do what. I mean, I think there's a little confusion about the process here, so we'll at least deal with that. So anybody else have anything to say? Yes, Ned first.
I guess I'll start with a question, and that is, I wondered whether the Charter Review Committee is going to resume meeting. That's the question, and then if they do, I wish they would address the concerns that Mr. Curran expressed in his memo to the committee. I wish they would address the question of an elected county executive. That was the second part of the that we haven't gotten to talk about yet. I wish they would discuss recall and the question concerning the possibility of a charter change making some or all of the Cape Cod Commission elected.
I will pass those. I've been holding back on meeting in the Charter Review Committee because we've had some not ongoing discussions, not involving me or the committee, but involving staff, basically, as to where this is going. Mike seems to be, we're concentrated right now on exactly defining what the actual charter says now, which is something we've drifted away from. In other words, we're sort of casually observing what is in there. His feeling is, and I agree with him, is that the charter says what it says, and so we should observe its conditions and so on. And so we're trying to relate that to the current practices in Barnstable County. But yeah, I'm the Charter Review Committee members, and no other than mentioning names, have said in no uncertain terms, I don't want to have too many more meetings, and I don't blame them. So when we refine exactly what we're going to be deciding and voting on, we'll do that. And we have Mr. Curran on board for a little while longer, and I will include your requests in our deliberations as soon as possible. Okay, now, Cheryl.
Well, thank you, Mr. Speaker. I think you answered my question. It was more a process question for me as well. I mean, various members of the public are calling us up and asking us, gee, can the Charter Review talk about this, or can the Assembly talk about that? And I don't really feel like writing up an entire ordinance to ask the Charter Review Committee to deliberate on something if a simple suggestion to you will accomplish the same purpose. So if you're saying that's all we need to do, then that's enough for me. And do you have any idea how long the committee, you know, what their timetable is?
2 minutes.
Well, I would say that it was going to be done before May 1st, you know, I would think. You know, I don't want to bring anything of any substance before the committee while we're discussing the budget. But we'll see. I mean, the time to really go into the ballot has run down to a precious few. So we're going to see what we can do within the authority we have to change it, and not to go to anything that's substantial enough to have to go through the whole process, because that could take forever.
Okay. Well, given your remarks, then I'll simply say, on the recall issue, I was curious to hear what the committee would say, only because
they say let's not do what Provincetown did. Use it as an example. No, I'm only kidding. We actually did consider the recall, and we voted not to include it. But I'll bring it up again.
Oh well,
is that right? Yes.
Okay, that's important. No, I didn't realize that. And the second one was the issue of the membership of the Cape Cod Commission being elected rather than appointed.
See, the problem is that the Cape Cod Commission is set up by a separate piece of legislation over which we have no authority whatsoever.
Okay, so that's in the Commission Act.
Yeah. Could I?
Yes.
Okay,
yes,
thank you. Really.
Again, that's helpful. Thank you.
I mean, I don't think it's crazy for the Assembly to discuss it, but I think there's two major reasons why I would not want that discussion to go anywhere. One, opening up the Cape Cod Commission at the State House runs some serious dangers from basically real estate lobbyists and developers who would be happy to gut it, frankly. Now, there could be legitimate things that would be good to change that would need a charter change by the commission. I'm not aware of any, but there could be. But there is that risk if those are brought up. I personally consider that this is enough of a regulatory agency that I feel strongly that it should be an appointed rather than an elected.
Well, we won't get into that under other business.
That's why I'm not interested in it coming up, but I don't see it as being relevant to the Charter Commission at all.
The only thing I see we do relevant to the Cape Cod Commission, I'll have to discuss it with the commissioners, is that it's part of the budget of Barnstable County. Now, we've been told in the past that we don't have any say over that because they have their own revenue stream. However, I have not read that anywhere in the charter or anywhere else.
Now, Mr. Speaker, we definitely have a review of their budget.
Right.
That is nothing, that is completely separate from their governance, which is part of.
Well, I'm just trying to say, these are the ties we have to the, we have oversight over the budget, we have to pass on changes to the regional policy plan, and we also have to approve any DCPCs. So that's where we are. But before we go too far down that road, we'll accept Leo's suggestion, we'll put it on the agenda, and we'll beat it to death. Okay?
Thank you.
All right, anybody else have anything to say? In that case.
Motion to adjourn. Second.
Okay, all those in favor?